You know, I'm starting to get old, and the older I get, the more I worry about cognitive decline. Vigorous, intense exercise has a myriad of benefits. So today, I wanted to address some of these benefits, especially the ones that hard physical training has on our brains. See, when going through vigorous exercise, your muscles are being pushed hard, which leads to substantial adaptations in the brain. Many of these changes are caused by one thing, and that is the release of lactate. Now, lactate can fuel the brain during exercise. During high intensity training, lactate is produced in high amounts, gets into circulation and crosses the blood-brain barrier and can be used by neurons as a preferential energy source. Now, neurons usually are glycolytic. They primarily use glucose as a fuel. It takes less energy, however, for neurons to use lactate than it does using glucose. Since your brain is working harder during exercise, being able to use this extra energy from lactate helps keep the brain functioning at a higher rate. Now, that's also important because lactate use spares glucose to be used by other pathways, such as the pentose phosphate pathway. So the glucose can either be converted into ATP, adenosine triphosphate. I'm pretty sure you still remember this from like high school biology, you know.
The mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. The mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell.
And it uses ATP as a primary energy source. Now, glucose can either be converted into ATP or go through the pentose phosphate pathway, for instance, which uses glucose to produce precursors that are needed for one of the most powerful antioxidants in our system, and that is glutathione. So the more glucose can be spared by neurons through the use of lactate, the more NADPH, which is this precursor to glutathione we talked about, can be produced. Now, it isn't only helpful when it comes to brain aging, as glutathione helps protect the brain from the wear and tear of aging, but also has a special relevance for instance, traumatic brain injuries. Studies show that patients with TBI getting infused with sodium lactate saw a significant improvement in their recovery outcome. So lactate is energetically favorable when it comes to neural energy consumption. And that favorability helps us use glucose for other important things. Now, lactate is also a signaling molecule in the brain, practically allowing for direct communication between the brain and muscles. When neurons in the brain use more lactate, they produce more neurotransmitters like norepinephrine, which helps with focus and attention, an amazing benefit to have as well. But it also signals the brain to produce, for instance, more BDNF, aka brain-derived neurotrophic factor. Now, this one is very crucial. BDNF promotes the growth, function, and survival of neurons, basically everything that neurons need. It also plays a crucial role in neuroplasticity, your brain's ability to change, adapt, and learn, giving us a direct correlation between physical activity and improved cognitive function, as well as learning ability. And a major one for me, protecting against neurodegenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's, which honestly is one of the things that scares the shit out of me. Now, people like Dr. Rhonda Patrick, for instance, call BDNF the youth elixir for the brain. By the way, if you don't know her yet, Dr. Patrick specializes in like longevity research. If you're interested in this topic, she'll have way more information to give on this platform than I can even process. So go check her out. Back to lactate. Now, lactate is also a messenger at the blood-brain barrier, not just the brain itself. The BBB is made of like many tiny blood vessels. Now, BBB breakdown is a major cause of neuroinflammation and brain aging. Now, even more important, the latest research suggests that the breakdown of the BBB is one of the earliest signs of dementia. So lactate signals for another growth factor in the BBB called VEG F, which is vascular endothelial growth factor. Now, this helps grow new tiny blood vessels, a process called angiogenesis, and helps repair damaged blood vessels. So VEGF helps increase the vascular density of our BBB, promoting blood flow, which in turn helps with the efficiency of like other neurotransmitters, and round we go. Now, those are just some of the benefits we get from increased lactate. We didn't even scratch the surface of other benefits of rigorous training, such as general increased blood flow, improved cardiovascular fitness, the release of neurotransmitters, endorphins, increased strength and hypertrophy, increased mood and better sleep. And if I had to break all of these down, we'd probably be sitting here until tomorrow. All of these things also contribute to brain health, be directly or indirectly. So if you can add at least like one session of high intensity training to your routine, you'll be surprised at how much quality of life improvement you can have, especially as we age. Now, building a good physique is great and all, but what's the use of it if you can barely like form a sentence, remember your loved ones, or play chess at the park with the other seniors while complaining about today's you?
I hate to burst your little after-school special bubble, but I'm not some kind of loser. I have a perfect life.
So if you are looking to protect your brain, age gracefully and stay as sharp as you can, I'm pretty sure you have at least one person in your social circle that suffers from like Alzheimer's or dementia or any neurodegenerative disease. And if you got to experience any of that firsthand, be it from a relative or any other sort of loved one, then you know that it is not only taxing on the people themselves, but also on the people that surrounds them. So take a hint, go do some high intensity exercises. With that said, sadly, that's all the time I've left for you today. However, if you like the video and subscribe, and please check out other videos on this channel because we literally have new ones every single day. And I will see y'all guys tomorrow. Captain Cairo, peace out.